In this video lecture, we want to talk about Java's next lexical elements, its list of reserved words, which collectively constitute Java's entire vocabulary. Okay, let's get started. The reserved words, or keywords, in any programming language such as Java are the full list of symbols which have special, recognized meanings in that language. Taken together, they constitute Java's vocabulary, and you can think of them as being like the list of words in a dictionary. Just as you really can't use a dictionary word for anything else beyond its defined meaning, so too all of Java's reserved words have special meanings in the language. So what this means is that we can't use any of these reserved words as identifiers in any code that we write. We can't use them as names for anything we create, such as variables, methods, or classes. And even though Java is case sensitive, we really should avoid using reserved words alone as identifiers, even if we do make them uppercase or mixed case. But using a reserved word as part of a larger identifier would be okay. For example, int with a capital I would be a very bad idea, but int counter would be okay. Here's a full list of all of Java's reserved words. You can also find this list in this week's lecture module, as a URL to the official list on Oracle's website. We can see that there are about 50 Java reserved words. Three of them, true, false, and null, aren't strictly speaking reserved words, but rather they are special literal data values. We'll cover many, but not all of these during the semester. As you can see in this list, the ones in green are the ones we'll deal with in this course. You'll probably see most of the remaining ones in red in the continuation course to this one. And there you have it. This list is Java's entire vocabulary, and the subset in green are the ones we'll be learning to use in our programs. Any other programming language you learn will have some comparable list of reserved words or keywords. So, that's it for reserved words.